So, ladies and gentlemen, starting 1 week from now, which is around 14th of March, from that time to 8th of May, Jupiter will be in Gandanta. Okay. Gandanta means, as you know, the word says Anta. Anta means ending. That means something related to that planet is going to end and a new cycle is going to begin. So we will discuss today what will happen when this Gandanta zone is being transited by Jupiter. Okay, so we all know what Gandanta is. Gandanta technically is the last 1 degree of the water sign and the beginning 1 degree of the fire sign. So for example, 29 to 30 degree of Cancer, 0 to 1 degree of Leo, then 29 to 30 degree of Scorpio and 0 to 1 degree of Sagittarius, then 29 to 30 degree of Pisces and 0 to 1 degree of Aries. These 6 degrees of the zodiac, they are known as Gandanta zones. Okay, so now Jupiter, as we know, is in the last degrees of Scorpio and it will enter Sagittarius on 14th. It is crossing 29 degrees, hence it will enter the Gandanta zone, and on 27th March it is entering Sagittarius, and on 10th April it is going retrograde, and then by end of April around it is entering Scorpio again, and on 8th May it is going retro from the 29 degree of Scorpio. Okay, so that means from 14th of March to 8th, it will hover from 29 degrees to 1 degree of Sagittarius. Okay, back and forth. So this is a very crucial junction, because they say that the poison of the scorpion is there. Okay, so now what does this mean actually? And yes, if you are new to the channel and if you have not yet subscribed, then please subscribe to it somewhere here there. And if you want a consultation from me and you are interested to know how this Gandanta zone will affect you, then you could always go to my website to book a reading. You'll find the link to the website in the description section of my videos down below. Okay, and yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. So now what's happening is Jupiter will enter Gandanta very soon. So you have to understand the transition from Scorpio to Sagittarius. What Scorpio is? Because Jupiter is in Scorpio, so we must discuss what Scorpio is. Scorpio is basically having the flavor of the 8th house of the zodiac. 8th house is what? 8th house shows all our weaknesses. 8th house shows the reasons which compel us to take birth again and again and again. 8th house shows all the temptations that we fall prey to. Alright, that is why 8th house is signifying addictions. 8th house signifies sexual obsession. 8th house is also the house of prostitution. Yes, all these things. Of course, 3rd house is primarily the house of prostitution, but 8th house also, because 3rd house is the 8th from the 8th. Okay. Physical attachment, that's what the 8th house is. That's why it's the house of the scorpion. Scorpion has poison. What does he do with that poison? He keeps hitting you again and again and again. And once he hits, you feel as if you are dead. Yes? What happens when you get separated from somebody who you love? How do you feel? Terrible, right? So that's the scorpion. That pain which we feel when something which we love is taken away from us, that's what Scorpio is. And that is why Scorpio represents the graveyard. Graveyard means it can have two implications. One is that you lose something. Because what happens in a graveyard? There is smashan, you know, dead bodies are burned. That means somebody has died. Or it could also mean, on a categorical sense, that something or somebody is there with you, but they are as good as if they are not there for you. They are always there, but they are never available. Okay, so when planets transit in the planet in the sign of Scorpio, then we could get a feeling that something has become too much of a burden for us. We could get that feeling. So you will see that. Now, how to know? It's very simple. Check whichever houses Jupiter rules in your chart. Okay. By that, I mean wherever the sign Sagittarius and Pisces is falling in whichever house. Okay, for the newcomers of astrology, number 9 and number 12. So, those are the lordships of Jupiter. Lordships means they are the ones whose agenda Jupiter is carrying. And the house where Sagittarius and Scorpio is, that is the house where... Now, why do I say Sagittarius and Scorpio? Because Jupiter will dance between these two zones. Okay. And of course, Sag is its Mool Trikot own sign. So, Scorpio and Sagittarius will tell you in this transit, in your birth chart, as per your ascendant, where is Jupiter going to fulfill its agenda? Remember, agenda is the lordship. So, suppose Jupiter is your lord of the fourth house, for example. Okay. So, suppose you are a Virgo Lagna, then Jupiter is ruling your fourth house. It also rules your seventh house. Because the sign Sag and Pisces falls there. So, now, the agenda of Jupiter is, first of all, the home. Yes. Vehicles, property, then it is also marriage. Then suppose it is transiting in Scorpio or Sagittarius. So Scorpio is which house for Virgo Lagna? Scorpio, calculate 6, 7, 8. So Scorpio is the third house. That means Jupiter is telling that I will fulfill the agendas of home, property, land, vehicles, real estate, and marriage, and partnerships and business through the third house, which means short distance travel, through meeting people, through communication. That's how, through writing, through social media. That's how we read transits. So we see the lordships and then we see which house the transit is happening. So to fulfill the agenda of the lordship, we have to take the house into consideration. So now that means whichever houses Jupiter is ruling, he owns the agenda of those houses. Okay. And once the agenda is clear, then he is going to undergo a massive change now. Why? Because he is transiting the Gandanta zone. Okay. Gandanta means what? It's like a knot, you see. So suppose this earphone is there. Of course, now it's sorted. So you cannot say there's a knot, but suppose it is, it's in a big messy state. So then you will see that you are not able to use this properly. Okay. So suppose I put the earphones here, it doesn't work like this. So regarding the houses which Jupiter is ruling in your chart, you must have got a feeling from last year, October 12th, that there is something which you are constantly trying to do, but it's not happening ultimately. It is somehow not happening. Some obstacle, some problem, some dissatisfaction or some reversal you are facing again and again and again and again. Okay? At least I have felt this. I don't know about you. And many people have told me this, that lordships of Jupiter has gone for a ride since the time it has entered Scorpio, especially when it has entered Jyeshtha Nakshatra. Okay, so this means that now the knot is going to open. So it's like this, it's like the earphone which is messed up, but now Jupiter will come and he will open this knot. It's still difficult, you see. So that's how the knot gets clear. So you will realize that after 14th of this month, 14th March to 8th May, you will gradually see that now you are able to see behind the scenes. So which can mean either of the two things. You get clarity of something which is already existing in your life. You will get clarity, or something is ending and something new starts. Either of these two will happen. Okay, it will happen, it has to happen, depending on what your dasa is like. Now, what that will be, that the dasa will decide to what extent it will be. So, for example, if the dasa is saying that you will have great success, so it could happen that in career, for example, so it could happen that you are ending a particular job and then you are getting a big promotion. Okay, or if the dasa is saying that you will have a downfall, then the opposite could happen. You could end a job and then you have to downgrade yourself. That could also happen. If it is saying that your health is not going to be good during this dasa, okay, then it could happen that you suddenly encounter some new disease. And then during these 2 months, it's almost 2 months, right? 14 to 8. During these 2 months, you will see that you have taken some treatment which you never took before. So that is how you study the Gandanta zone. Okay, it's a very important zone. And the good thing is now the knots will be untied. Yes, I can understand how difficult it has been. At least it has been for me. I don't know for you. So now we have to understand what the nakshatras are. Okay, in this context, Jyeshtha Nakshatra is the one which is in the last degrees of Scorpio and in the beginning degrees of Sagittarius. It is Mula Nakshatra. So now Jupiter is entering Mula Nakshatra 0 degrees on around 27th March. Okay, so that means this, and on 10th April it is stationing. So that means the period from 14th of March to 27th, that is very crucial, because that is when it is starting to enter the Gandanta zone. So starting means it is starting to untie. So the clarity will happen between those dates. All right, 14th to 27th March, and from 27th to 10th, what is going to happen to 10th April? You will see that now the new picture is in front of you. Okay, and then of course then it will go retrograde again. So that means there is something which you might do wrong, which you will redo again during the retrogression of Jupiter. Anyway, so retrogression of Jupiter, I will explain in another video. I'll make it somewhere around April. But this Gandanta zone is very important. Okay, so if Jupiter is ruling, suppose your education houses, 4th house, 5th house, and to some extent the 3rd house, then if you are doing some PhD or you are doing something related to masters or bachelors or anything or any project related to education, then now is the time that you finish it off. Okay, and one of my friend, he is a Sagittarius rising, he is doing his masters here in Germany. So for Sagittarius, Jupiter rules which houses? The 1st and the 4th house. So he himself, his whole life, ascendant is the whole life. And the fourth house is education. So he is going to submit his thesis on 25th or 26th or 27th, around that time he told me. So that means now he's in his fourth lord, and the Lagna lord is transiting in the Gandanta zone. It is going to transit, I mean. So during that time, the knots will be completely untied. And he will give the defense, which is the presentation for his thesis, master thesis, somewhere in first week of April. I told him give it before 10th April, before Jupiter goes retrograde. Alright. And I told him that try to give the presentation on 28th or later, because 27th around Mercury is stationing. So around 28, 29, 30, 31st if you could give, that's great. I mean the final submission of the report, the deadline he said is there till 31st March. So there you see how this is happening. Or if the dasha is telling that you are a Sagittarius rising and you will buy property, then maybe now you go and sign the papers. That could happen. Or if the dasha is telling that you will move to a foreign land, so now it could happen that you have gone to the foreign lands. And now you are planning to settle down. You are planning to take a home there in the foreign lands. Okay. So that is why Gandanta zone is very important. So there is a lot of fear about the Gandanta zone. But Gandanta zone is very good actually. Because how miserable it is to stay in a mess, right? Either something works or it doesn't work. It's very simple. There's nothing in between. Gandanta means enough is enough. Throw it. Bahut ho gaya. So now the knots will be untied and you will see the results coming. Okay. So that is what I wanted to say. And this is a very important transit of this year. And later on also Jupiter will again go to the Gandanta zone because it will go retrograde, and after 8th May it will go retrograde from 29 degrees back to Scorpio, and then later on in October again it will cross this Gandanta zone. Okay, so that time will again be very important for all of us. But that is like a direct motion of Jupiter, but this motion is very crucial because on 10th it is going to be retrograde. So, and the entire retrograde motion is happening in the Gandanta zone, 0 degrees and 29 degrees. Okay, so that is why this time is more important than the time which is in October. All right, so I will also make a video on that, nothing to worry about. So that's all I would like to say. And if you want a reading from me regarding this Gandanta zone on how it will affect you personally, then you could go to my website to book a reading down below. And if you are new, then please subscribe and click the thumbs up and share it with somebody who wants to know about the Gandanta zone. Okay, until next time, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him like the sun is shining brightly. Okay, and he will be there. Okay, until next time, bye bye.